Each and every day, we're exposed to information that for some reason we accept to be true without questioning that possibly that it's false. What if a majority of the things we learned at school turned out to be incorrect? We might have been told that certain things were safe, but it turns out to be au contraire. From what really happened on the 4th of July, the truth about what's actually a planet, here are the biggest lies people used to believe.
Hey guys, this is your host today, American Eye, and I'm bringing to you one of my favorite topics. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the video.
Chameleons changing color. Many people might believe that chameleons actually change their color in order to camouflage more effectively. This is surprisingly false. They in fact change their color on a variety of different factors such as a response to mood, temperature, communication, and light. For example, if they're hot, they might actually change a different color which will reflect the sun better to help them stay cool. The panther chameleon will change color to red or yellow before they're about to go on an attack. Other males hope that some bright colors will help them attract a fine lady lizard and begin a mating ritual. Some people who own these lizards will also know that they might change colors when they're feeling sick. You need 8 hours of sleep. We've all heard it before from our doctors that we all need to get 8 hours of sleep each night. But what if you like staying up late? Some people don't get tired at the normal time and can possess the power to sleep only a few hours and feel completely fine. Although it's only been recorded in a few cases, scientists are beginning to believe in the possibility of a short sleeper mutated gene which could affect less than 1% of a human species. Historical figures like Napoleon Bonaparte, Leonardo da Vinci, and Margaret Thatcher have all reported only needing 4 or less hours of sleep per day. In any case, the amount of sleep you need to get is determined by your age, if you're sick or not, and how much energy you exert in one day. The bottom line is that everyone is different. Shaving causes hair to grow faster. It turns out that this is wrong. Some might have actually heard the misconception that shaving can actually make your hair grow back thicker, darker, and more dense. The reason for this belief is that when you shave, the hairs will get tapered ends, and the hair feels more coarse due to the sharper edges. Cutting the hair with scissors will make it less sharp, and your beard won't feel like the needles of a cactus. In any case, your hair will grow back the same speed, length, and thickness as usual. Exercising more important than diet. Before, everyone just thought you can still eat whatever the heck you wanted to and not gain weight as long as you exercised. A new study would prove a lot of people wrong. In fact, it would suggest that diet is greatly more important than exercise. Exercise is certainly important and all, but it's going to take a dedicated nutritional plan in order to lose weight. Exercise is even known to make some people even hungrier and can often trigger some people to binge eat after exercise. And we're all probably guilty of this. Overweight people often tend to underestimate the amount of food they eat and have a bad sense of what's healthy and what's not. Working out too much can even lead to injuries, release of stress hormone, and even cause you to gain weight. Pandas only eat bamboo. You might find it to be rather strange that a bear would only eat plant matter, and many believe that that's what pandas prefer to eat. The truth is that pandas would certainly eat other animals, but they're kind of slow and aren't great hunters. Bamboo, on the other hand, doesn't move too quickly and makes for a great prey. Pandas will occasionally eat other animals when they get the chance, though. Pluto was a planet. NASA told us that Pluto was a planet, and they're wrong. What else could NASA be wrong about that they're not telling us? Perhaps the real shape of the Earth? Who knows? But they were certainly wrong about Pluto in any case. In 2006, a meeting in Prague took place in order to define exactly what a planet was. A planet is a celestial body that orbits the sun, has a sufficient mass for self-gravity so that it assumes a round sphere shape, and has a clear neighborhood around its orbit. It was the last criteria that screwed over Pluto. It shares an orbital belt with the Kuiper belt objects, which ultimately stripped it of its planetary title. Twinkies last forever. Many urban legends exist about Twinkies, and some claim that this product doesn't actually contain food, therefore is not spoilable. Some claim that Twinkies have been on storage shelves for years and wait until people make orders for them, making them one of the best apocalyptic foods out there. But is this myth true? According to many sources, the Twinkie has a shelf life of only about 25 days since it contains actual ingredients like milk and eggs. However, this is actually pretty long for a pastry. Twinkies still appear to be rather edible long after this time, but the taste will certainly be diminished. Albert Einstein failed math. Do you really think one of the best scientists and mathematicians actually failed math? Maybe your teacher told you this once or twice after a bad test grade to cheer you up, but don't fall victim to their lies. He'd really have to be one heck of a renegade slacker to pull off that kind of feat. Although his teachers didn't really believe he was a genius at first, Albert Einstein did get some decent grades. He might have not done great in other subjects, as he did with math, but when you're the guy who came up with E equals MC squared, that doesn't even really matter at that point. Interestingly enough, his least successful class during school was French. He did flunk an entrance exam into a university of Switzerland, but he did exceptionally well on both math and science. Plate armor. A common misconception is that plate armor is difficult to maneuver in, but it was actually even easier to move around in than chainmail. If it's correctly fitted to your body, it will not make a big difference. Plate armor is still quieter than its medieval counterparts, and it would be one of the best options for the zombie apocalypse. Plate armor is durable and reliable and used for centuries in battle. You don't think they would have used it so often if they couldn't move around in it properly, right? The 4th of July. What do we celebrate on the 4th of July? The signing of one of the most important documents of all time didn't take place until August 2nd, 1776. So what the heck are we celebrating exactly? The Second Continental Congress had voted to declare independence on the 2nd of July, and the final document was actually approved on the 4th of July. It was then printed and distributed on this day and the following day. Acne. Many of us might see the stereotypical teenager with acne working at the drive-thru at Wendy's and think, dang, that person really needs to wash their face, but it might not actually be their fault. Those who are at risk of developing acne are those with hormonal changes, stress, coming into contact with grease or oils, and a carbohydrate-rich diet. Acne isn't necessarily a result of bad hygiene at all, and you might have your parents to blame on this one. Genetics play the largest role, and if your parents had a bad case of it, there's a good chance you will too. An underlying evolutionary reason why people find acne to be unattractive could be because people don't want to pass down the acne genes to their offsprings. If you do have acne that you're trying to treat, consider using apple cider vinegar. George Washington Carver and peanut butter. Despite finding many uses for peanuts, the famous American inventor George Washington Carver didn't invent peanut butter. He discovered that peanuts could be used for many things such as shampoo, shaving cream, and glue. But he didn't come up with the most practical use for peanuts as an edible paste. Even if somehow he was able to invent it, he didn't get the patent for it. Marcellus Gilmore Edson of Canada held the patent for peanut butter, which was originally used for treating malnutrition for people who couldn't chew properly. Who wore it first? Very tall mohawks were a fashion trend in the 1980s, especially among the punk rock scene. These might have started in the 1970s, but rose to popularity in the 1980s. This was basically done to look as outrageous as possible and to make people's parents regret the decision of having kids. Originally worn by the Pawnee tribe of Indians, it's actually a misconception that these were worn by the Mohawk Indians first. Cinco de Mayo. Do you think you're celebrating Mexican Independence Day during the Cinco de Mayo? Don't spit out your tequila just yet. It was still an important day in Mexican history, but it definitely wasn't the day that they became free Mexicans. It's actually a rather minor holiday in Mexico and doesn't have to receive that much attention in the US. It marks the victory over the French during the Battle of Puebla. Mexican independence was declared over 50 years before the Battle of Puebla. Mexican Independence Day took place on September 16th, so now you know the truth. Napoleon's height. During history class, you might have remembered your teacher referring to Napoleon as a short man, possessing what's known as the Napoleon complex. This is used to describe how shorter men tend to act more aggressively in order to scare off bigger competition, similar to a way that Napoleon did under a confrontation. But the only problem with that is that Napoleon wasn't really all that short in any case. He measured to be about 5.5 feet tall, which wasn't staggering, but average height at that time for a Frenchman. He was also known to surround himself with taller soldiers, which made him look shorter in comparison. Scholars believe that the origin of belittling Napoleon for his height was a part of British propaganda at that time. GMOs aren't bad for us. People are starting to wake up and realize that genetically modified foods are completely safe for those who consume them. But it's starting to seem as though America is the last to realize it. Countries around the world have banned the importation of GMOs. Half of the European Union wants nothing to do with the Frankenfoods, but mysteriously, the animals actually eat genetically modified feed. It's not always necessarily the food itself that's the most harmful, but the herbicides that get sprayed on them. Nonetheless, the weed killer known as Roundup, which is not only used on weeds but also on GMO products, lost a huge court case for causing a school groundskeeper to get cancer. The groundskeeper won almost $300 million. The judge stated that if it was any less, Monsanto would have cracked open a bottle of champagne and celebrated. Monsanto was also recently sold to Bayer for over $60 billion.